Every day I'm hustling. Every day.
Why don't you two introduce yourselves?
Hello, I'm Nadya.
And I'm Esmeralda!
And this is our love child, Kizzy.
Is the word gypsy a derogatory term?
I'm Romani Gypsy. I don't think there's a derogatory word. All Romani are gypsy, but not all gypsy are Romani.
It's not uncommon to see honest Roma contradicting themselves by saying the word gypsy is both racist at the same time acceptable. The word gyp definitely carries a negative connotation meaning to cheat. We prefer to be called Romani.
If you like our people, our name is like music to you. If you hate us, every one of our names, even Roma, would be bad for you.
Do all Romani originate from Egypt?
You... All the Roma are originally from the Indian subcontinent. It was around the 1300s that the forming of a gypsy legend was in motion. There were many different reasons leading up to the choice to leave India.
It's a fact that during that time, India was undergoing great conflict. Their land was being ransacked and their people killed. We were invaded by Muslim Afghans and harsh Turks 17 times. Many were taken as slaves to Persia, where they were held in the Byzantine Empire. When the empire collapsed, it forced them to escape.
Western Europe and Asia looked promising, but before arriving in Europe, we spent time in the Orient, Persia, Armenia, Greece, and Turkey. When we escaped our homeland, we integrated into a variety of countries, but sadly never adopted a land of our own.
Some of us settled down, but most of us continued our state of nomadic existence.
So then what is the origin of the word gypsy?
Although we have only passed through Egypt, someone in the Middle Ages firmly believed that the Romani originated there. Gypsy is a word that is derived from Egyptian that describes the Romani and other groups of nomadic people.
Gypsies prefer to call themselves Black Dutch, Ludar,
rom'nies, or Manouche, which means man or to be human.
How did you find your way to Europe?
Running along southern Germany, Austria, Hungary, Yugoslavia, Bulgaria, Romania, and a bit of Czechoslovakia is the Danube River. On the banks of the Danube River, you will find two famous cities, Vienna and Budapest. The river sustained our needs, especially when we first arrived in Europe.
We carried with us our own rich culture, which we blended with other cultures as we migrated and intermarried. As we moved into Europe, we took with us bits and pieces of Ottoman, Turkish, Byzantine culture and folklore, linguistics and religion.
By the 1500s, Gypsies came to Hungary, Spain, France, and England. Romania holds the highest concentration of Gypsies, and Rome the lowest. Together, they numbered around 100,000 in the UK, about half nomadic. Oh, I think Kizzy here is getting tired. We'll have to continue this interview tomorrow.
This is day two of the interview with Nadya, Esmeralda, and their love child, Kizzy. After the arrival in Europe, were the Roma banned from any countries?
In the 1500s, the Augsburg Reichstag Diet issued the condemnation of Roma, declaring them traitors to the Christian countries, and accusing them of witchcraft, kidnapping of children, and banditry. In 1504, Louis XII banned Roma from living in France. The Grand Council renewed the ban, where a second offense resulted in hanging.
We were expelled from Catalonia in 1512, Denmark in 36, Scotland in 41, and Lithuania in 56. In Denmark, the death penalty is ordered for any Roma who failed to leave the country.
In one narrative, they were exiled as punishment for allegedly harboring the infant Jesus.
When did the Roma first set foot in America?
Spain had already begun shipping Romani to the Americas in the 15th century. Three were transported by Columbus to the Caribbean on his third voyage in 1498.
I understand Roma have many different languages.
Oh yes, there's rom'nies, Kale, Nokins, Mincer, and more.
According to these stereotypes, us gypsies travel with family and live in Conestoga wagons or old caravans. They are said to be thieves, cheats, or liars, but we don't fit these stereotypes at all. We are no typical gypsy family.
It's been said that gypsies do not bathe often and are uneducated, apparently. They wear baggy clothes and usually have black hair with little dark skin. Females wore huge hip earrings and lots of rings.
They are swindling. Actually, they have six cents, carry around a crystal ball to gaze into, and they generally have ravens as pet birds. They have great knowledge in palmistry or fortune-telling.
The stereotype that is true is their nomadic lifestyle. They carry with them small livestock for manual labor. They are trades and crafts workers. They move with the seasons and never settle.
but all the other stereotypes are not true about us.
What words are common in your language?
Pendukuren means fortune-telling. Gajo means non-gypsy. Vardo means caravan or wagon. And Hakani Boro means the great trick.
Hakni Panki means trickery, or the literal definition is honky panky.
Considering that your most commonly used words consist of fortune-telling, trickery, and the great trick, the stereotypes of stealing, cheating, and lying that you claim to be false are in fact true?
Nadya, do you have any sevens?
No, go fish.
Every day I'm hustling. Every day I'm hustling. Who the fuck you think you're fucking with? I'm the fucking boss. 745, white on white, that's fucking Ross. I cut them wide, I cut them long, I cut them fat. I keep them coming back, we keep them coming back. I'm in the distribution, I'm like Atlantic. I got the motherfuckers flying across the Atlantic. I know Pablo, Noriega, the real Noriega. He owe me 100 favors. I ain't petty, nigga. We buy the whole thing. See, most of my niggas really still deal cocaine. My roof back. My money ride. I'm on the pedal, show you what I'm running like. When they snatch black, I cry for 100 nights. He got 100 bodies, serving 100 lights. Every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling.